What's up, y'all? Welcome back to the channel. Ron Kwok here, and in today's video, we're talking daily backpacks. What makes a good backpack, features I'd like to see, and of course, one special candidate that might just be my new daily workhorse. Stick around until the end to catch the full breakdown. Let's go. So what makes a good bag? Well, first things first, it's got to be able to carry the gear you need it to carry. What kind of gear is that? That's entirely up to you. And because you live with purpose, which means that we custom tailor our loadouts to suit our specific needs, no more and no less, the first step on the path to a better bag is to sit down and really narrow down your loadout. From there, you can start to narrow down your bag selection by size and by feature set. Do you need a full-blown 28 liter that can convert into a 34 liter for traveling or weekends? Or will you be able to make do with a more compact 16 liter bag? Another aspect of a great bag for me is that it's made out of sturdy premium materials. I need my daily bag to be able to endure. I need it to be able to keep up with me on all of my adventures, and the last thing I would need is for it to start falling apart while I'm out there in the field, where I need it most. This is a great point to start considering what types of environments you're gonna be putting your bag through. Will it be exposed to the elements? And therefore, will ripstop or water resistance be an important factor for you? Really dive into the details and specifications on the product website so you can really see what the straps, the zippers, and the fabric itself are made of, just so everything is on the table when you're considering the perfect daily bag for you. Finally, the bag has to be comfortable. If you're gonna be carrying all of your gear on your back or taking it, hauling it over longer distances, the interface between bag and body has to be dialed in. And so I'll be looking at the straps. Are they thick? Are they padded? Made of foam? Breathable? Does the back panel of the bag have any added foam or padding that'll further cushion that weight that's going on your back? These are all things to consider when you're talking about the comfort of the bag. Now you might be going, Ron, I'm watching you break this down, and I see all this footage of a certain bag. I see that bag on your back, and that's not the typical daily bag that you've shown us in previous videos. Well, that's because it's not. This is the Able Carry Daily Backpack. Able Carry is a team from Hong Kong that set out to master the urban bag. Now, considering that Hong Kong is as dense and urban and skyscrapery as you could possibly get, they have the perfect environment to really hone their craft. Big shout out to the team over at Able Carry for sending this backpack out to me for review. It's been a great couple weeks, and I've been really able to put the bag through its paces out in the field. So thanks, y'all. Let's dive right in, shall we? The structure of the bag, as well as the build materials, all lend to a final product that can keep up with whatever you can throw at it. It's got dedicated pockets for specialized gear like laptops or cables and chargers. And of course, the straps and the back panel are all over-engineered to give you that comfort for those of you who just might need to haul this bag all day long. So just taking a look at the bag from the outside, two things become readily apparent. First thing is the A-frame system here at the bottom. The system is tied directly into the straps, and what it does is it keeps the bottom of the backpack pretty rigid. That way it prevents the bag from sagging while you're wearing it, as well as when you've set it down, and it increases the overall durability and rigidity of the bag at large. It also provides a decently rigid frame for the backpack to sit upright while you're not wearing it, so you don't have to worry about it sagging too much. The other thing you'll notice is the fabric of the backpack. It's made from X-Pack material, which is the same fabrics they use in racing sails, a sport where the materials used must be as lightweight as humanly possible, but also strong enough to withstand the elements when it's out there racing. To me, that sounds like a perfect material to make a daily bag out of, especially since you're gonna be taking it day in, day out in the field, and it has to be reliable. And of course, since it's gonna be on your back, can't be too heavy. So good choice with those materials. On the front of the bag, there's a quick access front pocket that unzips almost the full height of the bag. Here you can store quick access things like a pair of wool gloves during the winter or a tech organizer. There's also a leash here for more valuables such as your keys if you decide to stow it in here. There's a sturdy handle up top, making it easy for you to carry the whole bag by hand if you need to. It's made from the same straps and webbing as the A-frame system. I've got my hero clip here in case I need to keep my backpack off the ground when I'm on the go. There's also a secret top access pocket up here for your more valuable goods. I keep my Kindle or e-reader in this pocket because I like reading on the go and I want to keep it readily accessible. Note that while the X-Pack material in this bag has a layer of waterproofing over top, the bag itself is only water resistant. If you guys find yourself out in a torrential storm or rain, Able Carry does offer a rain cover made specifically for this backpack. It fits real snug and keeps your gear nice and dry. Diving into the main compartment of the backpack here, we've got a large 20-liter volume to work with, a dedicated laptop sleeve that can accommodate up to a 15-inch laptop. Got my tech organizer here, a large mesh zip pocket, as well as a few other pockets both zipped and open to accommodate accessories of different sizes, whether it's your full-on laptop charger or smaller accessories like a pen and pad. One thing to note is that Able Carry just recently upgraded the interior lining to ripstop fabric all around with the latest iteration of the Daily Backpack, just to add extra durability to the interior to match and complement the already super durable and weather-resistant exterior. So what do I think of the bag? Well, after using it for a few weeks, I've gotta say, it's a solidly built bag. Like, it's a tank. Even though it's not heavy at all, you can really feel the thickness and the premium quality of the materials. That racing sail fabric is no joke. Like, it's, you can see the striations of the X-Pack. It's real subtle, but at the same time, it's rigid and you can feel like, it's almost like a tarp, like nylon thick tarp. And then when you lift up the whole bag, it's super light still. And 20 liters is still plenty for me to accomplish everything I need to in a day. Another thing I love about this bag are the subtle details they've really worked into this bag. The sleek and minimal and subtle design they've done with this bag is, I love that stuff. That's a really unique look, you know what I mean? I haven't seen any backpack that looks quite like this one. You've got elastic strap stays here. You know, when you tighten your straps and the loose end just kind of dangles everywhere, they have a stay built in here. It's a small feature, but the fact that they worked it in here and thought about that, it's a really nice touch. One thing I didn't like about the backpack is that it doesn't have a dedicated bottle pocket. Now, hydration is really important to me and I carry a 24 Man, I almost said 24 liters. A 24 ounce bottle. I always carry a 24 ounce tequila bottle with me to make sure I stay properly hydrated. And although you can, you know, open up this front access pocket and slide that bottle in there, it'll accommodate. But because it's in, you know, one of the compartments in line with the main volume of the backpack, I could see having bulge issues, like this whole top here would be bulging out because of the bottle once I put more things into the main compartment. And so to have a side bottle pocket, whether it's like a minimal elastic sleeve or what have you, would have been a nice touch to kind of round out the backpack. But they have a lot of features packed in here already, so I mean, you modify your loadout accordingly, I feel. And so the dying question, will I be using this bag as my new go-to workhorse on the daily? Hell yeah, man. That thing is solidly built, the design aesthetic is on point, and it's comfortable. The straps are thick, padded, feels real good, even at max capacity. And I'll be real, I was gonna use this as my tech bag, my coffee shop loadout, if I wasn't in the middle of testing it and making sure that it checked all the boxes for me. But with that dedicated laptop sleeve, it's perfect as the bag addition to my coffee shop loadout. If you wanna check out that video, I'll go ahead and link it right here. If you wanna learn more about the Able Carry Daily Backpack, I'll go ahead and link it in the description below, just so you can do your due diligence and definitely take a look for yourself, because that bag checks damn near all the boxes for me, and it's a solid contender if you're looking for a new daily backpack to roll with. That's it for this video, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this one and learned something from it. If you did, let me know by hitting that like button down below, subscribing if you haven't already, and make sure you hit that notification bell to be notified whenever I release new videos on everyday carry and gear. Until next time, live with purpose. And I'll see y'all. Peace.